already know what it is, man. Salute to the subscribers. That notification gang, et cetera, et cetera. Don't let none of that get too far ahead of you. Yeah. Showtime SP, salute to my guy also. You know what I'm saying? He just delivered a baby girl. The nobody that knows babies. He should be back in a couple weeks. You know what I'm saying? Got to handle your handle. I know if it was up to him, he'd be out the door right now. You know what I'm saying? Get ready to show, ready to get on the show. But I'm like, no. So we'll see him soon. Prayers and wishes to him, and salute to everybody that sent their well wishes to him and his family. Mom, him, and baby are doing well. You know what I'm saying? But I brung clips. Time to get into all of the dumb ish. So Kayshawn, salute to Kayshawn. He's been more active on Twitter. You know what I'm saying? He's been talking. He's been expressing himself lately. And I think that a lot of these guys with platforms should be more accessible. And I know Kayshawn in the past has said that he didn't really do like social media like that, as far as like Twitter and or real social media, because it was giving people access to troll him and to talk crazy to him and things like that. And he was just saying, you know, a lot, once you get in a position, like, you know, you start to rise and you bubble and you meet your come up, there are a lot of people that just wake up in the morning and that will say anything to you. You know what I mean? And it's like, you know, it's just random people that'll be like, F you, this, that, and the third. And so a lot of times people just want to protect their peace. And I would suggest that by all costs, protect your peace. But at the same time, I think it's good to be accessible to your fan base. You know what I'm saying? The people that support you the most, you should have some accessibility to them. So he's joined, he's been on Twitter, has a pretty big following, but he started to like use it more, talk to people, retweet, joke, and people are seeing a side of Kayshawn that probably wasn't seen. I would say you really haven't seen, because a lot of the time, you know, a lot of people, this in this game, you hard, you want to be, you know what I'm saying, et cetera, et cetera. But he's, you know, he cracks jokes. He was cracking jokes this weekend when the whole royalty event was going on and things like that, retweeting people and just engaging with his people. But he was talking about his next battle. He said, and I quote, "This might be one of my toughest, if not the toughest match yet." And that led to a lot of people to guess, who would it be against? Would he be battling against Chess? Would he be battling against Charlie Clips? While those matchups are difficult, you know, this was just my thoughts, you know what I'm saying? I ain't get no word, or I ain't heard, chipper bird, nothing like that. I ain't heard, get the word from a bird, or nothing like that. I'm just saying, I think one of the most difficult matchups for Kayshawn right now would be none other than somebody who raps like this. And I tweeted this the other day. You know, I said, "You be cooking dudes, bro. The bullets shoot slow. You kill people and rap in real life. Look at you go." Pat Stay. I think Pat Stay would probably be one of the most difficult matchups for Pat Stay, because Pat Stay is a guy that not only is he one of the most popular battle rappers in the world, he's one of the most popular battle rappers in the world, but he's got a huge fan base, he's unflappable, and he's able to do a multitude of things in the ring when it comes down to rebuttals, when it comes down to personals, when it deals with cadence. He can do damn near everything. Pat Stay, you've seen him in a lot of his URL battles, most recently versus a Tay Rock, he won that, versus a Shotgun Shug, it was a closer fight, but I still had him winning that. He can go toe-to-toe with some of the best MCs in the culture, he can come out unfazed. I mean, Pat Stay just has a way about going and doing what he does, and it just makes, he's just a very hard MC to beat. Now, what I will say is, Kayshawn has stepped his game up a lot. You know what I'm saying? He's stepped his game up in the past couple years. I will say that. You know what I'm saying? I will not say that he has, you know, stepped up his game, stepped up his performance, and he's done it from a lot of different levels. Because Kayshawn, when he first came, you know what I mean, he had the cadence, he had the performance. And he aspired to be one of the Harlem greats, you know what I mean? After the T-Rexes, after the Murder Mooks, you know what I'm saying? He was that guy, you know what I'm saying? But he stepped from the background to the forefront, and now, you know, he's running with, he does his thing with the NWX, And he's definitely relishing in the moment right now. But I think, like I said, I think a Pat Stay will be a difficult matchup for him. If that's the case, you know, like I said, it's just my personal opinion. You know what I'm saying? My opinion is just that. You know what I mean? But I think, if you ask me, a very difficult matchup for him would be a Pat Stay. You know what I'm saying? I just think that Pat Stay is problematic and troublesome when it comes to MCs. You know, you can't, the things that you could do against other MCs don't work against Pat Stay. You know what I'm saying? Like, it just does not work like that. You can't thug him. He's freaking 6-something. You know what I'm saying? 2-something. He's a tall dude. He has a big presence, and you can't just thug him. You can't just like bully like that. That type of stuff is not gonna work with a Pat Stay. You know what I mean? Like, life don't work like that against Pat Stay. So if you're asking me, Wild Chess would be a more suitable matchup for him in terms of him having to battle somebody that's closer. I wouldn't say easier, because Chess right now, Chess has been wigging. If you ain't see Chess versus Tory Doe, that's what she was doing the whole night anyway. You know what I'm saying? And then I'm not gonna go too much back into the royalty event, because you know Debo, he's in his feelings right now, and I don't, for the life of me, I can't understand why you would have feelings about an event that went, a lot of them battles that went like that. And as a paying customer, if I paid to see it, you know, I didn't get it for free. I paid to see it. I should be able to have my own perspective without somebody intervening, thinking that, you know, it's you gotta respect, man, whatever. So we're not gonna do that. So y'all know, you know what I mean? And the funny thing is, you're never gonna see Organic, you're never gonna see Smack, you're never gonna see ARP, you're never gonna see like a lot of these big league owners going back and forth with bloggers online. Like, they're not gonna do that. You know what I'm saying? Like, your opinion is just that, you know what I'm saying? But he takes his so personal that, you know, it clouds the judgment, you know what I'm saying? And at the end of the day, I think I told somebody yesterday, as long as I pay, I got to say, and I'm going to say what I want, and that's just going to be the end of it. I don't have to go with the grain. I can go against the grain. I'm just going to do things my way. You don't have to like it, but I got my own platform. You don't even have to watch it. Remember that. But, you got K-Shine, you know what I'm saying, doing what he does, but I think that the best matchup, the most difficult one for him, would be against the Pat Stay. That's just my personal opinion. I'm going to throw another one in here that, I was gonna do a blog on it, but I figured I'll just throw this in here. We'll throw this subject in here. You know, you get 2 for 1, you know what I'm saying? Who just keep watching and we keep dropping, you know what I'm saying? Av has spoken on the New Jersey twerk battle, or the lack thereof, or the battle that did not happen. I really don't speculate. I don't wanna move into speculation or hyperbole as far as what went on with that matchup. I wasn't there, I don't have intel, and I don't really speak on streets, things that happen in the streets. To me, like, my channel is derivative of battle rap. You know what I'm saying? Like, I talk about the battles, I talk about the winners, I talk about the losers. I don't get involved with, you know what I'm saying, real street situations, or, you know, that's just not me. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm sorry. It's me and Showtime SP. We want to rap about the battles, things like that, and that's just what we do. So, when I hear all of these rumors and this happened and that happened, and this is why the battle didn't happen, I don't know nothing about that. So you ain't going to get that from me, and you're not going to ever get me to speculate on it either. I know that the battle was supposed to happen twice, and I know it didn't happen twice. So Av has moved on from the situation. And Av said, and I quote, somebody named JMO1671 said, "This finna be the crazy one. Av second best puncher, and Twerk just Twerk got potential battle of the year written all over. And Avro F that battle. F that battle," in capital letters, "F that battle." And someone else said, "Ain't meant to be. Glad Twerk's still here." And then Av said, "I definitely do not have personal beef with him. I'm certainly glad he didn't lose his life or freedom. I just want to move forward from the situation." And that's commendable of Av, you know what I'm saying? A lot of people would have been, you know, bothered or immensely disappointed by the situation, but he's just saying he wants to move forward from the situation, and you got to have respect for that. You know what I mean? He's not looking for the battle. And I think he said in some other tweets, like, don't bet on the third time. And as fans, we put so high stipulations and such high, you know, acclaim and things that we want on the artists, and they got to do this and they got to do that. But when you look at it from where Av's perspective is, you know what is, unless you a battle rapper or unless you prepare material and you go to, you know what I'm saying? When you doing all of that, you preparing material, you coming up with rounds. I'm sure he has some crazy material for him that he's not going to get to use against him. And you do it twice, like twice, you know, you're not going to want to do that no more. Like, he doesn't want to do that. And I don't blame him for it. Like, why would you want to do it again? He did it once, didn't happen. Did it twice, it didn't happen. He's not going to want, he don't want to take that battle no more. And I don't blame him, you know what I'm saying, in regards to that. Like, I don't blame him for not wanting to do the battle again. Like, no, give me somebody else. It's time to move on. Maybe in the future, now, I ain't talking about, like, next couple months. Future, maybe a year or two from now, when the situations are better and, you know, it's guaranteed to happen on a bigger card or something like that, maybe it could happen then. But for now, Av is like, nah, I'm good. I'm good. But other than that, hopefully everybody, you know, is doing good with themselves. It's 2020. We about halfway through the first month. And, you know, you guys have to get on your game, man. Stop waiting around. A lot of y'all wait around and y'all want things to happen for y'all, but y'all not, like, jumping out there, taking a chance, taking a risk. Some people, they want to go back to school, but they don't go back to school. They keep waiting to go back to school. A lot of people want to start a business. A lot of people want to start blogging and things like that. Like, dude, just do it. Like, you have to step out there and make the first step. The houses are built by one brick. You have to use one brick in order to build a mansion. A mansion started by one brick, and you have to think about it. Like, yo, the people that you around, I think that's the thing that takes a lot of people or ruins a lot of people, is the people that they're around. Like, a lot of the time, you'll have a good idea and you'll want to do something, but the people that are around you will tell you, nah, you can't do that, or nah, you can't do this, or nah, you ain't going to be able to do that. You know what I mean? But if you can't gain nothing from the people that you around, and you can't learn nothing, or y'all can't build, they don't have to be on one accord. But if they're not on no accord with you, then you might need to remove the people that's in your circle. Like, you really might need to think about that. Like, yo, I'm trying to do this, but all they want to do is chill or smoke or chase women and stuff like that. I'll be honest with you. The most successful year I ever had doing this was the year that I stopped going out, stopped partying, stopped really drinking like that, stopped hanging out, stopped being around things that didn't add to what I had going on, you know what I'm saying? And we all have to, you know, dig down deep inside and intellectualize, what is it that you want? What is it that you're trying to accomplish, and how can you get there? And you need to rub shoulders and be around the people that can help get you there, you know what I'm saying? Like, I've done a lot for not just myself, but for my partner, Showtime SP, you know what I'm saying? Like, his growth and his development, it means a lot watching people, you know, respect him and show him love, you know what I'm saying? And he got so much love when his child was brought into this world. And that's just off the relationship that we've been able to build and accomplish. So, you know, anyway, off my soapbox, man, it's a lot going on out here in these streets. Y'all make sure y'all safe out here first and foremost, you know what I'm saying? Like, as black men, you know, we under attack. So, y'all, you know what I'm saying? Y'all know what I mean? Y'all know what I mean? But anyway, you already know what doing what it does, so you got to ask what it was. Salute to the subscribers, that notification gang. And I know there's a lot of people asking about the merchandise. We about to re-up with a bunch of merchandise. And when you see it, cop it. Because when it's gone, it's gone. So, you know, we'll move that accordingly. But other than that, you already know what it do and what it does. One.